Welcome back to Total F1. In our attempt to bring you the latest updates relating to the 2024 season, we're going to tell you some interesting facts about the AlphaTauri F1 team. The Faenza-based team is at the edge of a bigger transformation process, and after introducing those changes, team management hopes to bring the team to the front of the pack. So let's talk about their transformation process in detail. But before we proceed, hit the subscribe button and smash the bell icon for more exciting updates. The most significant change they would experience in the upcoming season is the name change. The Italian racing outfit began its journey under Red Bull ownership in 2005 as Toro Rosso, meaning Red Bull in the Italian language. But with time, considerable differences developed between Red Bull and its sister team, as Red Bull won championships when Toro Rosso hardly broke into the points. As a change to their marketing strategy, Toro Rosso was rebranded with the name of Red Bull-owned clothing brand AlphaTauri ahead of the 2020 season. Even though many had hoped that the Italian racing outfit would improve in terms of performance, no special change happened, staying further in the midfield. Four seasons later, they are now ready for a name change again, as all of their marketing and racing plans failed. Official confirmation has been given regarding the matter, but yet to announce their new name. When considering the changes in the management level, they are going to experience their biggest change since the establishment of Toro Rosso F1 team, as their long-serving team principal, Franz Tost, has decided to step away from F1. He was with the team for the last 18 years, enjoying moderate success. However, Tost carefully looked after Red Bull juniors like Sebastian Vettel, Max Verstappen, Daniel Ricciardo, Pierre Gasly, and Carlos Sainz until they were experienced enough to take on the duties at top-level teams. Now Tost's era is officially over, and the former Ferrari man, Laurent Mekies, is ready to step into the team principal position from the next season onwards. However, Mekies is not a new face to the team. He joined the Toro Rosso setup as a race engineer several years ago and was later promoted to roles like chief engineer and head of vehicle performance with experience. But Mekies left the team in 2014 to become the safety director and deputy race director of the FIA. However, he decided to leave the governing body in 2018 and joined the Ferrari team. Since then, he worked at Maranello before moving to Faenza. Other than that, Red Bull management also decided to hire former FIA executive Peter Beyer as the CEO of the team. All these changes have been introduced with the aim of boosting the team's performance, and most probably, the team will go through a full transformation process under the new leadership, as the new CEO and the team principal are experienced enough to lead the team into a new direction. Even though AlphaTauri is the sister team of the Red Bull team, they had no closer connection in terms of technology over the last two decades. Both teams were designing the majority of their challenges separately, and that's why we saw such a vast difference between the two teams despite the same ownership. Red Bull was always successful, winning seven drivers' championships within the last 18 years, but AlphaTauri managed to record just two race victories within the same time frame. As a solution for this ongoing problem within its sister team, Red Bull has decided to go for a closer collaboration with AlphaTauri. That means AlphaTauri will use parts designed by Red Bull as much as possible for its 2024 challenger. This news raised the eyebrows of many rivals, as everyone knows what type of things can be done on the racetrack with Red Bull technology. According to the unofficial news coming from the F1 world, some teams have already urged the FIA to take a closer look at things happening around this partnership, as they suspect something unfair will happen. But Red Bull team principal Christian Horner defended their partnership, stating that their relationship will be nothing like the one between Mercedes and Racing Point that created the pink Mercedes controversy in 2020. You can remember how Racing Point was extremely powerful throughout the 2019 season, thanks to the technology that they got from Mercedes. However, the Silverstone-based team was finally found to be guilty of breaching some regulations. There is a possibility for the same thing happening with the two Red Bull-owned teams, and AlphaTauri can be more powerful, even staying within the limits set by regulations for the transfer of parts. Talking more about this new close relationship, Red Bull team principal Christian Horner said, "We're an awfully long way from a pink Mercedes," he said. "There are some transferable components that are clearly listed within the regulations that you're allowed to supply, and that's what they get." When you look at the car, there are quite fundamental differences between that car and a Red Bull racing car. And arguably, there are other cars on the grid which are far closer in concept than an AlphaTauri is. You've only got to look at an Aston Martin or even a McLaren. If you look around the rear suspension of a McLaren, it's very close in concept to that of our own. According to Christian Horner, the performance of AlphaTauri on track is totally on its own hands, as the final design of the AlphaTauri Challenger is going to be decided by the engineering team at Faenza, but they will include a considerable amount of parts supplied by Red Bull into their 2024 Challenger, making it more powerful. "It's down to the quality of people that will be in the team," Horner said. "Of course, there are certain components that we can supply, as is the case with Mercedes and Ferrari, that supply current Grand Prix teams with gearboxes, suspension, and simulation tools and wind tunnels. And that is an identical relationship between the companies. Of course, it is then down to them and how they use those tools. You can see that McLaren have used those tools, in certain respects, better than their supplier has done in half of the year. It's really down to them how they make use of what they're permitted within the regulations," he added further, defending the accusations against the new partnership between Red Bull and its sister team. Step by step, Red Bull ownership is arranging all the things in the proper place to push their second racing team to the front of the pack. However, this is not the first time that they're trying to do so. From our point of view, they will surely achieve considerable success this time, as the Faenza-based team is going to utilize more Red Bull technology than in any other attempt. AlphaTauri has well-experienced Daniel Ricciardo in their lineup, and if the Challenger is powerful enough, it can challenge even the current champion, Max Verstappen, as well. What do you think about the current momentum of the AlphaTauri F1 team? Will it be able to break into the top of the pack in the upcoming season? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel to get more exciting Formula One news. See you in the next video, guys. Goodbye.